Brent crude, the global benchmark, going through $80 a barrel. What does the rising price of oil mean to a business like yours?
I mean, normally speaking, obviously, that has a big impact for our customers. If you take a long haulage operation, fuel typically stands for probably between 30 and 35% of the total cost of operation. Normally also for our customer, they have also an agreement with their customers to compensate for certain movements in the oil price. So right now we are in a good market. It will probably not affect too much, but if it prevails, it will have some movements, obviously.
A good market is a bit of an understatement. Mm. You're in a great market right now. Demand for trucks is really through the roof, and you beat your profit estimates in the last quarter. Do you expect that to continue, or are we sort of as good as it gets as far as truck demand globally?
No, I think, I mean, it depends on what region we are talking about. Europe, I think, is continuing on a good level, but it has been a steady growth, not too quick, so to speak. So that is more, stable from that perspective, and still very good activity level that we can see from all our connected trucks. When we see North America, it has been a very strong bounce back after pretty troublesome 2016, so that is on a high activity level. And again, we see that also on customer activity. E-commerce, for example, booming, and that is obviously also pulling out a strong demand for us.
Now, what are you showing here in Berlin at this innovation summit?
What we are showing is actually what we can do with the new technologies of automation, connectivity, and electromobility combined with new business models, both in the area of public transport, buses, or bus systems, but also construction equipment. And we have a world premiere of a new tractor unit for transporting goods in primarily confined areas, but also on some public roads. And that is a world premiere, a tractor unit without a cab. So that is fully autonomous, fully electric, and fully connected.
So one of the reasons I ask is that you, it seems, benefit from increasingly stringent regulation. You'd think that a truck maker is hurt by that, but actually, as regulations get tighter and tighter, as far as especially environmental standards are concerned, people need to buy more, newer, more technologically advanced products from you.
Yeah, you can say that. Obviously, what is needed when it comes to regulation is that you have a long-term view on the regulation, so we can plan in advance and drive our research and development in that direction. That it needs to be stringent over time, and not at least when it comes to emissions and noise, etc. So we are putting the bets in the right corner. But otherwise, I'm positive to that, because when it comes to safety, when it comes to environmental standards, I think we know that we will transport more goods, we will transport more people with growing demand, and it must be more sustainable. So that's the reason why we're driving it.
How are the trade restrictions or the tariffs that Donald Trump is slapping on China and vice versa affecting you? I know you have a lot of production in the U.S. Mm-hmm. You own Mack trucks, which a lot of people may not know, and you have production in China as well. So are you getting hit by first order issues when it comes to tariffs?
When it comes to the first order issues, we are getting hit to some extent, and we have some side effects, obviously, that maybe has not been seen also by the government. For example, I mean, we are 100% US when it comes to our truck production, and some of our competitors, for example, are based in Mexico. And then you can import steel to Mexico with zero tariffs, but not import. And then import trucks with zero tariffs, but we need to import steel, for example, with tariffs. So in some ways that has an unbalanced, given the fact that we have 100% of our production in Virginia, Maryland, in Pennsylvania, for example.
So how do you see this playing out then with the global trade?
I think the
war?
Biggest, depends on the development. I mean, we are depending on free trade. We are a small country, Sweden, but we have operations in all major regions. We believe that we should take responsibility of being where we are also selling and being present. So we have production and development in the United States or in North America. We have it in Europe. We have it in China and India. So from that perspective, we are very dependent on predictable development. And therefore, I think the more general economic development will be more be more critical to us, depending on the development, basically.
I have to ask you finally about the Hurricane Florence, headed for your East Coast operations, really. What have you done? What does that do to your production?
First of all, I mean, safety first. That is a mantra in the group since ever. So, I mean, the main priority, obviously, is to make sure that we are protecting colleagues and also other stakeholders around that, our suppliers and transporters, etc. That is the main priority. And therefore, I mean, we are following very closely that, and I'm in regular contact with our North American leadership around that. So we are following it, and we are prepared also for what will happen since we are primarily East Coast based.